हेलो एंड वेलकम टू आसान है एजुकेशन। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द परमानेंट स्टेटस ऑफ इंडिया एट यूएनएससी यूनाइटेड नेशन सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल। व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट आर फेस्ड बाय इंडिया इन अचीविंग परमानेंट सीट एट सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल एंड वी विल ऑल्सो सी व्हाट आर द स्टेप अहेड इंडिया कैन टेक टू अचीव द परमानेंट सीट एट यूएनएससी। ओके, सो लेट्स डिस्कस दिस इशू इन ग्रेट डिटेल। सी, डिस्कस इंडियाज पोजिशन इन गेटिंग क्लोजर टू परमानेंट मेंबरशिप ऑफ यूएनएससी। वट इज़ यूएनएससी? यूनाइटेड नेशन सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल। सो वट शुड बी आवर अप्रोच टू डिस्कस दिस क्वेश्चन? सी, वी हैव टू फर्स्ट स्टार्ट बाई मैंशनिंग द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ यूएनएससी एंड इंडियाज ग्रोविंग स्टेचर इन ग्लोबल पॉलिटिक्स। वी हैव टू डिस्कस द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ यूनाइटेड नेशन सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल, दैट यूनाइटेड नेशन सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल इज द ओनली यूएन बॉडी विच कैन इशू बाइंडिंग orders on every other countries and its main motto is to restore peace and international security. And we have to also discuss the growing stature of India in global politics and why India should get a permanent seat at Security Council. Then we will also indicate the regions that strengthen India's claim for permanent membership in the UNSC. Then we will also see what are some of the potential arguments that India should tell United Nations that we should get permanent seat at Security Council. We will also see some of the challenges or roadblocks which are stopping India from getting permanent seat at United Nations Security Council. Then we will conclude accordingly. Okay, so let us discuss. See, United Nations Security Council has primary responsibility under the United Nations Charter for the maintenance of international peace and security. However, the UNSC has been criticized due to its undemocratic nature, misuse of veto power, etc. So, United Nations Security Council is a P5 countries group plus 10 non-permanent members are also there. Which are these P5 countries? United States, UK, France, Russia and China. So these countries are called permanent 5 members of United Nations Security Council, and on every 2 year 10 non-permanent members are also there, which rotate every 2 year. Okay, so United Nations Security Council's primary responsibility is for the maintenance of international peace and security, but this Security Council has been criticized because of its undemocratic nature and misuse of veto power. Okay, so let's discuss some more points. See, thus there is a global consensus for UNSC reforms. In light of this, India too advocates for UNSC reform and a place as a permanent member of the UNSC. So due to its undemocratic nature, because only 5 countries are dominating this UNSC and they are vetoing policy or program of United Nations according to their national politics, and it is undemocratic nature which forces India to push for reform at United Nations and seeks permanent seat at United Nations Security Council. So see, what are some reasons for which India should get permanent seat? Reasons for India to be granted permanent membership in the UNSC. India is the largest democracy, second most populous country and the fifth largest economy in the world. Okay, so these are some of the strength of India, that India should be granted permanent membership in the UNSC, because India is the largest democracy in the world, India is the second most populous country in the world, and India is the fifth largest economy in the world in terms of GDP, and India is also the third largest country in terms of economy, in terms of PPP, purchasing power parity. Okay, so we are the fifth largest economy in terms of GDP and third largest in terms of PPP. Let's see some more points why India should be given. See, India acquired the status of nuclear weapon states in May 1998, which brought it to equal footing of the existing permanent members of the UNSC. India is also a nuclear weapon state, as the P5 members are also the nuclear weapon state. India is undisputed leader of the third world countries. Who are these third world countries? Because we know after the Second World War, we have Cold War, where US was on first one side leading one group and USSR, that is Russia, on the other side, and third world countries were those countries which were not on the either side of US or USSR. Okay, so India is the undisputed leader of the third world countries, as reflected by the leadership role it played in the non-aligned movement, because India is the founding member of नॉन अलाइंड मूवमेंट एंड इट हैज ऑल्सो प्लेड वेरी गुड रोल अंडर बिम्स्टेक एज वेल एज इन सार्क ग्रुपिंग एज यू हैव सीन अंडर दिस COVID-19 पेंडेमिक वी हैव कॉल्ड सार्क लीडर्स ऑन अ प्लेटफॉर्म वी हैव ऑल्सो कॉल्ड टू हाउ टू टैकल दिस कोविड पेंडेमिक सो वी आर शोविंग अ लीडरशिप क्वालिटी इन थर्ड वर्ल्ड कंट्रीज एज वेल ओके Historically, India has been the founding member of United Nations. So, India was the founding member of United Nations and has been elected for 7 terms for a 2-year non-permanent member year seat. So, India has been the founding member of the United Nations and has been also selected for the non-permanent seat. Okay. So, all these regions compel India to acquire the permanent seat at United Nations Security Council. And also India contributes one of the largest military personnel in the UN peacekeeping forces. So India is the largest military peacekeeping provider to United Nations. India's candidature is supported by the 4 out of 5 permanent members. We have discussed which are these 5 permanent members: US, UK, France, Russia and China. So except China, all other 4 countries are accepting or promoting India's permanent status in United Nations Security Council, but China is blocking due to its all-weather friendly nature of to Pakistan. And India is also supported by G4 grouping, which includes Brazil, Japan and South Africa, okay? And the majority of United Nations General Assembly countries also support India's status in permanent Security Council. Okay, recently India has taken a proactive role in the regional and global politics. For example, Quad initiative, Sagar, which is security and growth of all in the region, and International Solar Alliance as well. So all these regions compel India to acquire permanent seat in the Security Council because India has taken a proactive role in regional and global politics. For example, we have joined Quad initiative, which include USA, Japan and Australia, and we are also having a Sagar vision, security and growth of all in the Indian Ocean region, and we have also initiated International Solar Alliance, and International Yoga Day is also celebrated by initiative by our Prime Minister. Okay, so all these initiatives compel India to acquire permanent seat in the Security Council, but there are some of the roadblocks as well. So let us see what are some of the roadblocks in India's path. India is being the non-signatory to NPT, Non-Proliferation Treaty, and CTBT, Comprehensive Test Nuclear Treaty, is cited as the reason by countries opposing India's candidature. So when India blocks India's inclusion into Permanent Security Council, China blocks India's candidature into United Nations Security Council, China says that India is a non-signatory to NPT, Non-Proliferation Treaty, and CTBT, Comprehensive Test Nuclear Ban Treaty. So these are the regions which are cited by China to block the candidature of India into United Nations Security Council, that India should first sign NPT and CTBT. But India has not signed this NPT because India sees NPT as a non-discriminatory, and it is favoring only to the nuclear weapon states and especially to P5 countries. Okay, China is the only permanent member of the UNSC opposing India's inclusion into UNSC, thus uses veto power against India's efforts to become a permanent member. This we have discussed, that China is the only permanent member of the United Nations Security Council which blocks India's inclusion into United Nations Security Council, thus it uses its veto power always to stop India's inclusion into permanent Security Council. And India is yet to prove its military prowess beyond the Indian Ocean region because we are heavily dependent on the weaponry import from the US and Russia for its military requirement. According to the SIPRI, Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, India is the third largest expender on the military expenditure. But India is heavily dependent on the import from other countries, for example, US and Russia. Okay, so India has to prove its military prowess. India has to spend on its indigenous development technologies for defense requirement, but India is presently heavily dependent on the US and USSR or Russia, so that India needs to prove its military power, that India is self-sufficient, so that India can be allowed to get permanent seat at United Nations Security Council. And poor performances in many socio-economic indicators like Human Development Index diminishes India's claim to leadership. India performs very bad at Human Development Index as well. So all these factors contribute to India's roadblock getting permanent seat in the United Nations Security Council. So all these things we have discussed, what are the challenges India is facing, what is the strength, what are the positive points that India should be given permanent seat in the Security Council. We have also seen some of the roadblocks why India is not allowed to get permanent seat in the Security Council. So at last, how can we conclude this answer? That India's international profile and capabilities make it a natural claimant to become a permanent member in the UNSC. That India's profile at global level is increasing day by day. However, in order to have a more legitimate claim, India must address its socio-economic indicators and dependency on military import. Okay. In conclusion, what we can say? Yes, it is correct that international profile and global image of India is getting clearer day by day and world is accepting the growing power of India. But at the same time, to have a more legitimate claim, India must work on its socio-economic indicators, like India should be moving upward in Human Development Index, Global Hunger Index, and India must reduce its dependency on military import so that India can have a more legitimate way or more legitimate claim to get a permanent seat in the Security Council. So in this video, what we have discussed what is United Nations Security Council and why India should be provided a permanent seat in the United Nations Security Council. Okay, thank you for watching. Have a great day.